uproar, like the people were confused, running helter skelter. Mm-hmm. The maze, you know, it's like, how important is the maze?
It depends which side of the law you are. The maze is a colonial symbol. Our constitution does not say we have maze as the final authority of the land. But it was inherited from the British, right? Assembly can meet when you have a quorum. You don't need to wait for the mace. And the mace, we have become something too important now. Everybody's talking about it. It's not necessarily has to be the instrument of operation in the National Assembly. It's not. But and that's school of thought. You know, when you have law, you interpret law in various ways. And say no, but the constitution, I think when the constitution that says you must have means in your front or ahead of you before you can perform the parliamentary function of the day law. I think when the world that says that. Right. I may be wrong, I never corrected. But from what I've seen so far, the maze is there as a collective authority in a way. But it's not compulsory that the snake will not sit with some of the maze. No. The snake don't sit. Once you find a quorum, you can sit in absence of the maze. But since our constitution does not actually fulfill any functional role in the means.
Okay, so moving away from the invasion, I'd like to talk a little about the election sequence that was changed. What changed? You know, what is your take? I learned that the bill has been dropped. Is it?
Yes. You see, if we look at Jonathan, yes, President Jonathan, they also change the civil election. I don't say anything special about it. People in this country waste time on this issue. Was only discussing in the National Assembly. Some people bring it to the National Assembly. The issue of election reforms, the only three clauses was what the president objected to. If concealed to about 300 clauses there. If that's the case, why can't you assume only that those three clauses out? Whether the sequence this one first, this one's last, to me, it doesn't make any difference to the electorates and the honorables. Or you believe that bandwagon effects can happen if you put as one first. And everybody, people are voting for so direction. When they are moving away from that platform, people are no more foolish now. The electorate are very smart now. They are using their intelligence now. So to make the president have not asked anybody to go and campaign for sequence change of election. It's just unnecessary diversion. That's it. And that to me, I don't think it's important.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Is there any other thing you'd like to comment on, sir? Any other thing on your mind?
The media event is this...
The stolen maze?
Yes, and the second election of stolen maze, and then the... Now the oil price has... the oil price has gone up. Benchmark was... 48.
Okay.
And you're not talking about the oil is on sale for 70 now. So definitely there should be excess crude oil. What we need to do with that is to make sure it's judiciously utilized. We don't waste anyone.
Okay.
Let's fix our roads, fix our power, fix our schools, fix our hospitals.
Okay.
Let's increase our securities. This economy country is also of concern to me. When you see the speed at which people have been killed every day, I'm just going to a television program, you just attack one people in one church, in Georgia somewhere.
My God.
It just flashes and says, if a country is losing an average of 100 people every day, why not that? The question you ask yourself, are we at war?
Hmm.
If we're not at war, no nation will be losing average of 100 people per day with any solution to it.
Hmm.
So the first point of any government is to protect citizens. When you cannot protect your citizens, then you are likely to return responsibilities. Nigeria, as a nation, find a solution, a land solution to the agony and pain of the rural community in this country. And it's those states, Taraba, Benue, Plateau, and Kogi, and the question I keep on asking is this. These communities have been living together for the past 15 years, 20 years. They are not fighting each other.
Mm.
They are not killing each other.
Mm.
What made them suddenly turn against each other and say, to see that something was going wrong.
Mm.
Went to investigate and find what went wrong. That mm. People who have been living together peacefully for the past 100 years suddenly become each other's troops. Then, once you can find answer to that, they will be able to address this issue. If you want to neutralize your place, it will not last long.
Mm.
Let's find out what is responsible.
Mm.
That is the way I feel.
Okay. Some people think it's ethnic cleansing of some sort.
Yeah, because when people say so, I don't want to give it that coloration.
Okay.
I want to give it terrorism, it's on the loose.
Okay.
When it can be any kind of land grabbing, it can be a effect of the desert encroachment.
Mm.
They are forcing people down south, going for greener pastures. There are so many line of thought, or school of thought,
mm.
that you can probably follow to. But as long as one ethnic group has been wiped off, those who are responsible are definitely not connected to an ethnic group. So that way, like, you can see the ethnic cleansing.
Mm.
So, but the solution I see to see on the global solution, because what I'm saying here, it will spread, it will come worse, and desert keep on encroaching south, coming southwards.
Okay.
So we need to sit down and have an ECOWAS conference on this. All those countries that are affected with this encroachment of desert should be brought to the table and find a line of solutions to it. Nigeria cannot accommodate the whole West Africa, it's not possible.
Mm.
If they do, then our quality of life will go down. So we need to sit down as a big family and look at it. Our nation is at a crossroad. This country is now swelling with feet of injustice and oppression. And we need to make it a common place. We are transforming it into oasis. We go and ask the quality of life. But that's only possible if we're all on the same page. If we all share our pain, our aspiration, our joy and tears. And that is the point where we are now. We are now at the crossroad. And that crossroad is cast on taking to what intent. So my take on that is that we should try as much as possible to leave this on the board before it spreads become uncontrollable.
Mm.
That's what the Nigerian population is intimidating. And if this corruption moves to West Africa, they will destabilize everywhere up to Ghana.
Mm.
So that's the way I see it.
Wow. Excellent, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Wow.